Centering Meditation. This is an introduction to the meditation. If this is the first time you have played the recording, what I am about to say will help to explain the meditation before you do it. The information is designed to help you to understand the meditation more fully and to experience more benefits from doing it. This centering meditation is a procedure for ensuring that you are as well centered as you can be at any particular time. What is involved in this is very simple. All you need to do is to identify your center and to align yourself as fully as you can with it. Both steps are important, the identification and the alignment. The instructions I give during the meditation take you through several ways of doing these two things. So what are the benefits of becoming and remaining well-centered? The first thing to say is that they are both general and specific. People who are well-centered have some obvious qualities. Their bearing radiates to others that they know who they are. They have a presence. Someone is there, someone defined, someone with poise and balance. They often seem surrounded by powerful auras and to affect others with their presences. Their very centeredness connects them to the life source available in their souls, just as it is in ours. The result of this is that they have a vitality that many people who are not well-centered seem to lack. People who are not well-centered are often very different. They often appear lost in life. They tend to over-focus on other people or to give too much emphasis to external situations and events. They fail to draw directly on their own life force, and they show the consequent debilitation directly. They know their names and addresses, however they don't know who they are in a deeper sense. Many are often uncertain of what they think, feel or know, particularly when they are with others. As internal or external pressures mount, they can easily lose sight of what is important to them. They seem inclined to be swept up in the most powerful forces in a situation. Practicing the centering meditation helps to attract the benefits I have just mentioned deeply and quickly. We can learn to find and to stand on a clearly felt and solid inner foundation. We can see things from our own perspectives and from the differences between these and the views of others. We can hear our own maladies and in the ways they harmonize or do not harmonize with other people's. Emitting our own fragrances, we can contribute to the beauty of others. Most importantly, we can find ourselves deeply and meaningfully by making soul contact and expanding this. The specific benefits of the centering meditation come from the way the more general benefits enter our lives in specific areas, through specific ways we approach things, or through the specific results that can and often do arise as we live well-centered lives. A short list includes: life energy nourishes and invigorates our bodies, and we can become healthier. A deep sense of self evolves. Love and joy arise naturally within us. We feel an increasing sense of inner completion. We find our sources of power within rather than outside ourselves. And we discover how to make and maintain soul contact. I want to emphasize that centering is of great practical value in many different situations too. For example, we can find the centering meditation particularly useful when we overfocus and lose ourselves in the other people and events outside us, need to take a stand with others, have little or no awareness of the situations around us, exclude others with our own desires and interests, perceive others wanting to dominate or manipulate us, need to increase our own sense of self, are low on energy or feel disconnected from our inner power, want to assert ourselves with poise and presence, want insight or intuition into what we are facing, or want to fill ourselves and our environments with soul energy. These are exciting possibilities, and it is natural to wonder how it all works. The first thing to understand is that human beings are designed to live easily, in balance, and with an ongoing sense of well-being. All our systems are designed to maintain these kinds of states and to re-establish them if we ever lose them. However, they can only perform their natural functions easily when we are well energized. And it is here that centering plays its part. Centering ensures that we stay well connected to the life force that is available within us. This life force or energy is what energizes us. It is the very aliveness that our bodies experience and express in every moment of our lives. When we are well centered, our systems flood with life and function as well as they were designed to function. When not well centered, the life force available to our systems is diminished. The effect is very much like turning down a dimmer switch on the lights or turning down the volume on a sound system. The reduced power reduces the output. Reduce it enough and nothing will happen. I have already mentioned that the way we ensure that we are well centered is to keep our awareness in the eye or observer in us. This is that part of each of us that knows what is in our awareness. We also need to align with this aspect of us. When we do these two things, we are well centered. That is, each of us knows the I in ourselves and lives in complete oneness with it. In effect, what this does is to keep us directly and strongly connected to the power source within each of us. If you think of a power socket in the wall at home as being the eye or observer, then we need to keep the plug, that is our awareness, firmly inserted into it. This enables the power from the socket, life, to flow into us through the plug of our awareness. One of the reasons that we need to learn to do this is that most people seem to become uncentered to some extent as they grow up. The expectations of our parents and other caretakers, the pressures of life, the way it often seems easier to manage if we reduce the intensity of our feelings and other experiences and other things, combine to encourage us to reduce our inner intensity. We do this by reducing our connectedness to our inner power sources. In effect, we gradually learn to loosen the plugs of our awareness from the sockets of our centers. We do this by diverting our awareness away from who we are and by paying closer attention to other things in our lives. From one point of view, this works very well because the reduced intensity does seem to make many situations very much easier to handle. We don't feel as confident, excited or loving, nor as frightened, sad or angry about things. Without this kind of intensity, the advantage we notice is that we can find it easier to manage ourselves as we make the decisions that we need to make in our lives and as we do the things that seem required of us. In other words, we experience having more control over ourselves and what we do. Unfortunately, there are significant costs to managing ourselves like this. I have already mentioned some of these and expand a little on this here. The main cost is that we can only reduce our intensity generally. We usually can't do it specifically. So we don't manage to reduce it only in certain areas while leaving ourselves to live fully in others. For example, We might like feeling loving and excited when we are with friends and loved ones, or like having lots of vitality when we have physical and other work to do, but not like feeling angry and highly charged when with our bosses or other people who seem likely to hinder or harm us in some way. However, if we reduce our availability to the life force so we can manage our anger with the boss, the effect spreads to those other situations too. If you loosen a plug, it is loose. The equipment is affected generally and won't work better in some situations than others. The centering meditation helps us to recover our natural aliveness and our natural sense of ourselves. This leads to powerful changes in many people that lead in turn to the kinds of qualities that I mentioned earlier, such as much more vitality and happiness, and acquiring a personal presence and balance when with others. At the same time, as we come into the natural intensity of life again, we need to have ways of managing it. As mentioned, most of us reduced our connectedness in the beginning for the very good reason that we did not know how to handle it in any other ways. Fortunately, an associated meditation called the grounding meditation helps us to do this very easily and naturally. The grounding meditation keeps us well connected to our bodies and to the physical world around us in such a way that our energies, our feelings, our thoughts, and the other parts of us stay in balance. Grounding helps us to keep our equilibrium, to digest and release discomfort, and to intensify and spread comfort throughout our systems. Taking account of our needs for grounding, the necessary steps for the grounding meditation are included on this recording, so you can keep your balance and equilibrium at the same time as you learn to get well centered again. If you want to explore this other very powerful process, you can contact the network for a separate recording of the grounding meditation. While different processes, grounding and centering are very much related. Each involves different steps, which, when combined, produce extraordinary outcomes for most people, so I highly recommend that you master both meditations. I now turn to discuss the meditation on this recording more directly. The meditation helps you to stay centered and to intensify how well-centered you are. And there are four general points I will make about it. First, when you do the meditation, you can realize very quickly that you are already centered to some extent. You are not learning to do something new. The meditation helps you to do something more fully that you are already doing. Second, while the meditation on this recording is for about half an hour, you can choose for how long you do it when you do it without the recording. You can do the meditation for only a few seconds at a time, or you can do it for much longer periods. Each time you do it, you can be making yourself more centered and so promoting the natural processes and results already mentioned. Third, the more you deliberately intensify or accentuate your centering, the easier it is to stay well-centered, because centering is a natural process. It takes far more to interrupt it than to let it occur. So the moment you start to encourage centeredness, all the natural drive of your system rushes to your aid to complete and to fulfill what is natural. The result is that when you center yourself deliberately, you will usually stay more centered for longer and longer. Eventually, you will be completely centered virtually all the time. Fourth, you can do the meditation in any situation while engaged in any activity, and it is completely private and instantaneously. Now, just before ending this introduction, I want to emphasize that the experience of centering is different for each of us. For any one of us, it is also different from one day to the next. Centering is to do with experiencing who and what we are on the inside, and we change every day, perhaps even every moment. So, as you learn to center yourself well, relax if you discover that you notice considerable variety in your experiences. They could include, for example, one specific center, more than one center through which you move serially, or several centers that you experience at the same time. Very defined, obvious, or confined centers. Centers that are diffuse, subtle, dissolved, or vast. Centers like bubbles of openness, quietness, or clarity. Ones that are stationary or moving. Physical ones that are located inside or outside your physical body. Emotional or feeling centers, thinking or cognitive centers, or spiritual, transcendent, locationless centers. Remember, as you experience whatever is there, that you are experiencing you or an aspect of you. The experiences of your center are of that part of you that is observing, noticing, and aware. The I of you. Just to summarize then, the value of being well-centered is that you are connected to your life force and to all the vitality that this makes available in you. With this vitality, all your systems and processes can do what they are designed to do. They keep you alive, fulfilled, balanced, and with a clear sense of self that is present in all that you are and do. If you have not yet experienced what this is like, it will not be easy at this stage to understand just how wonderfully different your life can be through using the centering meditation regularly. Even using it for only a few seconds at a time at regular intervals for the next few months can make an amazing difference. So, in addition to playing the meditation regularly, you can concentrate on centering for 5 to 10 seconds every 15, 20 or 30 minutes from now on in your daily life. Decide on the interval for yourself, then remind yourself. When you reach the end of the period you have decided upon, pay attention to the I inside you and align your experience with it for 5 to 10 seconds at those times. And within 6 months, your life can be transformed. All you do is follow three basic steps. The first step is to notice the physical sensations in your body and the physical things and events around you at the same time. This gets you well grounded. The second step is to continue to do the grounding and to notice the part of you that is observing whatever is in your awareness. Remember that this part could be very small and confined, or vast and inclusive, or many other things. When you have identified the I or observer, the third step is to align everything you're experiencing with your center by cultivating a simultaneous awareness of your center and anything else you are noticing. It generally gets easier to do this with practice. The whole process only takes a couple of seconds once we are familiar with it. We can also take as long as we want to take, which is wonderful, since the meditation is often exquisitely beautiful to do. You keep recycling these steps at your own pace until you feel centered, energized, free and alive. The more practiced you become, the easier these steps also become, and, I think you will find, the more you will do all the steps together as one act. I have now completed the introduction and wish you well with the results of the meditation.